Benchmarking in UX refers to the practice of evaluating a product's UX by comparing its performance against a meaningful standard. This meaningful standard is often a previous version of the product. So, a benchmarking practice will involve running the same study with the exact same study protocol and metrics on different iterations of the design in order to gauge UX improvement. To give you an example, a nonprofit website may run a quantitative usability study to measure success and completion time for a few important tasks, such as making a donation and subscribing to a newsletter. Then, after a few years, the company launches a new version of the website, and at that point, one legitimate question they could ask is, how does this new version compare with the old one? To answer that question, the company should run the same benchmark study on the new version, asking a new set of participants to complete the same benchmark tasks, namely, in our nonprofit example, to make a donation and to subscribe to a newsletter. Now, imagine that for the first study, success for the task of making a donation is defined as whether the participant reached the Make a Donation page, but for the second study, success is defined as whether the participant clicked the Make a Donation button on that page. These are very different definitions. If you find that the success rate drops in the second study, it could be not because the design was worse, but because the success definition changed. A comparison between the success measures obtained from the two studies would be meaningless. It is thus essential that if you are considering a benchmarking practice for your organization, you start by setting in place a research repository where you describe in detail the setup of your benchmark study for those researchers who will need to evaluate subsequent iterations of your design. This research repository, which could be part of your organization's overall research repository, should include information such as the screener that you use to recruit participants, the study protocol, including the type of study. Was it remote moderated? Was it in person? The study setting. Was it done in a lab, in participants' homes, etc.? Whether Think Aloud protocol was used, the initial instructions given to participants, any practice tasks given to participants before they started the actual study, task wording for each task, the order in which these tasks were presented to participants, and ideally, this order of tasks should be random, but that is not always possible. And any surveys that were administered to participants, and also when they were administered. Was it after each task, or was it at the end of the test? Your benchmark research repository should also include the metrics collected. For instance, task completion time, success, satisfaction, task difficulty, and their precise definition. Once you have documented your study, you're going to run it and collect your data. Make sure that you also add your raw data to your repository. It's not enough to store averages or other descriptive statistics. People who will run the same study on subsequent iterations of the design will need access to your raw data, meaning the success rates, the satisfaction ratings, the task times for every individual participant on every single task that they completed. This data is needed in order to be able to run statistical analysis to determine whether any observed differences between design iterations are due to chance or are statistically significant. In sum, a benchmarking practice is a great way to assess whether the UX of your product is on the right track. But it can give you sound results only if you clearly document all the details of the benchmark study, the screener, the study protocol, the metrics collected and their definitions, and finally, the actual raw data that you obtained for every single study participant.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, enngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our virtual UX conferences that offer live, hands-on UX training.